In this video, I'm going to show you templates in Home Assistant, what they are and how to use them. Make sure you stick around, and if you like what you see, make sure you hit subscribe below so you don't miss out on future videos. Hi, I'm Will from Will Surridge Tech, and today we're going to be looking at templates. We'll look at how to implement them into Home Assistant and how to use them to improve your setup. So let's get going. So what is a template? Well, you can think of a template as a way of extracting information, manipulating it, and then spitting it out as something else. It's a bit like a formula in Excel or a simple program that you might write to do something for you. You can get all sorts of different templates, from template sensors to template switches to even template vacuums. So there are two main types of templates. You either have input templates or output templates. An input template is like a sensor or a binary sensor, but you've got the information to fill that sensor from a different entity entirely, and you might have had to manipulate it to get it into what you want. Whereas an output template uses lots of different entities to create one overarching entity. For example, you might have a fan that has three different settings and so three smart switches to control it. With a template entity, you can combine those three smart switches into one fan entity. So what might you want to use an input template for? Well, I use a lot of mine to extract information from one entity and spit it out in another. This makes it easier to use in automations and to display in Lovelace. Let's have a look at my climate as an example. I have a separate climate for each of my rooms. In my case, these climates are created using Honeywell's EvoHome thermostatic radiator valves. Inside this climate entity is a lot of information. Some of it's quite useful and some of it's not useful. I don't really care about the set points. These are the schedules that I've created in the Honeywell app, because I don't use them. What I do care about is the heating mode and the temperature of each room. So I'm using a template sensor to extract that information and create its own sensor for it. So to integrate this, we add the sensor to our configuration file, or in my case, the sensors file, because I've got it referenced elsewhere. We add a new platform, which is the template platform, and then we can have a list of all our template sensors. So for this example, we'll have the bedroom temperature. We give it a name, i.e. bedroom temperature, a friendly name, bedroom temperature, and then the value template is what the value of the sensor will actually be recalling. So in my case, it's taking a state attribute from our climate.bedroom, and it's taking the current temperature attribute. The same applies to my heating mode, or heating status. It's the same principle, we name it, give it a friendly name, but for the value template, instead of grabbing the current temperature, it's grabbing the HVAC mode. I also have some template sensors for the sunlight. This affects how my floor plan is displayed. I'm so glad I could just copy these, because I really don't understand how they work themselves. I wouldn't have been able to do it myself. So shout out to Luke Vink on that one. If you haven't already, make sure you check out my video on creating an awesome interactive floor plan. As for actually writing the template, it works on Jinja 2 and their syntax. It's really well documented on the Jinja 2 website and also on the Home Assistant website. There are plenty of examples on the Home Assistant website and also on the Home Assistant forums to get you started and give you some ideas as to what you can do. If you head over to the Developer Tools tab, there's a template section where you can test out your templates and make sure it's spitting out what you're expecting it to. Another time you might want to use an input sensor is if you have continuous data and you want to categorize it and make it discrete. For example, if you have a clamp sensor on your TV that's detecting the power draw of the TV, you might want to categorize it. So for example, if it's 0 watts, then the TV is off. If it's less than 10 watts, then the TV is in standby. And if it's anything else, then the TV is on. So to add this, we add a sensor on the platform template, give it a name, and then the value template here is going to be an if statement. So if the value of our sensor is less than 2 watts, then it's going to be off. We're using 2 because it gives us a bit of wiggle room. If it's not the value 2, then it will move on to the next statement. In this case, less than 10. If it's less than 10, then it will spit out standby. Otherwise, if it fails those two conditions, it'll move on to the else. Else, it'll be on. And that's it. You can also use templates to combine sensors. So if you have a device tracker on two separate people in the household, you might want another sensor that tells you if someone is in the household. So to do that, you would just see if one or the other are active, i.e. in the house, and then you can set your input sensor to on or off if nobody's in the house. Of course, you could also use an automation and input Boolean to do this, but this is just another alternative. You can also use templates to change the icon or other attributes of your sensor. Personally, I prefer doing this in Lovelace using a custom button card. But if you want it to affect the entity as a whole throughout your environment, then you can use a template instead. As for the output template, it's the same principle, we're just merging multiple entities into one. You can create a template cover, a template switch, a template light, a template fan, or even a template alarm panel. So for an example for this would be our garage door. Let's say our garage door has a read switch sensor on it to tell if the door is open or closed. It then has one switch to shut it and another switch to open it. So to do this, we're going to add a lock to our configuration file using the platform as a template. Our value template is going to be getting the information from our read switch sensor. Then to lock it, we're going to turn on the switch that closes the door. And to unlock it, we're going to turn on the switch that opens the door. It's as simple as that. And that's all there is to it. Templates are there to extract or manipulate information. The more you use them, the more you'll get comfortable with the syntax. But as I said, it's really well documented, and there's loads of support out there if you get stuck. I hope you're enjoying my videos. If you haven't already, make sure you follow my social media. They're linked in the description below, both my Instagram and my Facebook page. If you have any questions or any problems, feel free to message me and I'll do my best to help out. Also, let me know if there's any content that you'd like me to cover in my videos in the future. I hope you have a better understanding of what a template is and how you can use it to your benefit. Make sure you hit subscribe below so you don't miss out on future videos about my smart tech and how you can build yourself the ultimate smart home.